leave a message, at least I could've learned your voice one last time. Daily minefield, this could be my time by you. Would you hit me? Would you hit me?
On the way, there was some young kids who had seen the show, and they wanted to present us with a petition that Pearl Jam was their favorite band of all time, and it was 350 students that all signed this, and they didn't know how they were going to get it to us. So I think one brave student decided he would smash his car into the bus on a kamikaze mission to present us with this. We succeeded.
But he's hanging out with us, getting ready for Lollapalooza.
I went and saw Soundgarden like a while back, and I noticed that the drummer had like lots of cymbals and little kind of things to play on.
Yeah, it's like,
if he's got 8 or 10 things to play on, I should be able to have like, you know, 8, 10, 12. And I went 2 up on him, 12.
This is my nap place. This is where I nap every once in a while. Whenever Scully gets everything out and gives me room to nap, this is the nap place. You can just reach up, I'll just pull it down. Good night.
Well, the name itself actually came from us sitting around just trying to theorize on a name and having a bunch of words, and Pearl was a word that kind of came up, and Eddie started to tell the story about a grandmother that he had whose name was Pearl, and talked about how she used to make like these preserves for her grandfather that were hallucinogenic, and just joking around, somebody said, you know, Pearl's Jam, and just ended up being Pearl Jam.
I've always just played real music, you know, stuff that felt good. Nothing ever felt as good as this, I must say. And that's why the opportunity to move to Seattle and change my life was taken up so quickly without much thought, because what Stone and Jeff were writing and Mike, it really hit me. It started bringing out things that no other music had pulled out of me before. You know, their music was like a blank canvas, or a canvas that, like...
Hey!
Came from a basketball player from the New Jersey Nets,
name, Mookie Blaylock, and we actually toured under that name, switching on it now. We toured under that name for a couple weeks, and it was just kind of an homage to him.
I think that was kind of what we were trying to express, and that there was a really short period of time where we worked really hard and really kind of let ourselves, you know, get into the music and to make music. And I don't know, that time was a pretty intense time in terms of like playing. I mean, we were in this little basement, and that was what, you know, we looked forward to every day. It was like going to the basement and playing this music and coming up with new music and letting ourselves just kind of go whichever way. And we ended up making a record like after we'd only been a band for about 3 or 4 months. So I think that's what we were trying to express with the album cover. I think it was the fact that the only thing that made this happen was the fact that we all came together and worked really hard and made it happen.
Well, I have to be satisfied because there's no way to change it now. And we just go out and play these songs live, and I think that's the best place to hear the music is live. It's much louder. You can jump around like crazy, and your parents ain't gonna tell you to turn it down. And you can kind of lose yourself even with headphones lying in bed. You can lose yourself. Live would be the place to see it. But then when you come home, if you want to get that feeling again, I think you can listen to the songs on the record and they'll be close enough.
Everything. I played everything from jazz. The band I was in before Pearl Jam was a funk band, and I also did every once in a while for some money. I played some reggae clubs with a reggae band, and just basically whatever I could. I mean, I never trained in anything other than just playing what I felt should be there. So that, I guess, that lent itself to me just bouncing around from different types of music and just kind of playing what I felt should be there. It worked out.
San Diego, the best parts of San Diego are the ones on the beach. And they're little communities where they're very close-knit and very little stores, tiny breakfast places. There was a theater there, a movie theater that had beds on the side. You could lay down and put your popcorn on the pillow in front of you, and there were waves, and the waves were the most important thing to me. Waves to me, when you went surfing, it was a connection to nature. I think that's something everybody needs to have.
Schedule, so I mean, our schedule is like right to September, we're on the road, and then we have a month off, and then we make a record. So we're not gonna have time to like
you know, think about all the success. I mean, more than anything, I think we really, really want to make another record, and we really want to make a record that we're like totally proud of, and like that we're like, you know, completely happy with, you know. So I think that's everybody's big motivation at this point. I know it's mine.
Gosh, there's too much to say. How much tape do we have? No. All right, hey, this is Eddie from Pearl Jam. I just want to thank everybody for listening. I mean that. Why? Because I never thought people in Japan would ever be listening to my songs. Never. So I think it's really cool, and I thank you for that. And I hope it gives you strength, knowing that just a little guy like me was able to do something and maybe make a record and get it over to your country. If you're out there, maybe you too can make a record. Maybe I'll be listening to it someday. And believe in yourself. Be strong, okay? Bye.